I want to talk a little bit about the golf that is down at the boat shed at the moment. It's a mini golf. Yeah, mini golf. It's not called crazy golf. It's mini golf. This is part of their conviction that nothing happens in the theatre in August, and they may be right. So the space is now a small golf course, and the advantage of that, from my point of view, is they don't mind photography or video. There's no image rights problems. So I've done a playlist, which is only a start on this, and I think it would be good if other people were to take some photographs or bits of video. If you put it on YouTube Creative Commons, it could be added to the playlist, or people might find it anyway. And the ones I've done so far don't have any sound on them, because I am gradually becoming convinced about the wonders of the Phonic FM studio. The microphones are very good, if I've got the levels right. Seems to be okay. So I think I'll get the sound eventually from a studio. This is all part of JD's listening. We're going to go outside the studio, especially in the summer, especially for video, because natural light is very good. We have tried out renting lighting equipment from the Phoenix Digital people, but you've got to carry it around. We're not sure the cafes welcome it completely if we take up too much space. But Film Friendly Exeter, we're going to try and get in touch with them and get some guidance on what you can do in a cafe. Or we could just talk directly to people in cafes. We're going to do that as well. So I'm rambling off. I'll have to edit this down to put sound on these videos, because I have got the videos down to sort of 15 seconds and 25 seconds. Anyway, I'm going to try doing this. There's one about Gandhi Street based on witches, and I don't fully understand how you're supposed to play it. There's sort of five different spaces you might end up in, and I'm not aware what the witch history is of Gandhi Street. So we'll have to do that one again. There's an Exeter map. You just have to be lucky and hit a straight line. You're going over a map of Exeter, roughly from where the prison is to where the gasworks is down by the canal. And if you hit it in one straight line, you're okay. If you don't, you end up in little bumps, which I don't know how you'd get out of that. The old Exeter Bridge, I thought it was going to be a sort of fairway, because the bridge, when you go and look at it, which I have done, that's another thing I think you should do with video that you come up with, is try and find the reality these places are based on. And there's a pretty good fairway that is the old Exeter Bridge, and it goes directly up to the cathedral. You could do it in one or two hits, which you're not supposed to do, by the way. Please don't go hitting golf balls around Exeter as such. But the one that's in the boat shed is sort of a lower level than that. It's all the arches and brickwork that's propping the bridge up. You've got to somehow get your route around. So it's a bit different, that one. And there's another one, another couple. The railway one, you've just got to be very lucky with your shot. I completely failed to do it. But if you can drive your ball up the hill, it will just go into a sort of chute, which will take it round the rest of it, I think. But I haven't seen anybody actually do that. And then there's one which I've called the Teen Valley. I can recognise the Belvedere, I think, at the top of it, and it goes down as far as a beach, but I don't know. I've never understood where the Teen River goes towards the end anyway. It might be accurate of something. Anyway, those are the ones I've managed to photograph so far. I'm just hoping that other representations will appear, maybe on YouTube, but other places as well, I guess.